Richie, take one mark.
One, two. I've been a musician my whole life.
Used to call me crazy.
That's all I wanted to do was be a musician and be a songwriter. I did four solo albums as a singer-songwriter. I joined as a creative person with Aerosmith, did some touring with them, wrote a bunch of their songs. Through my journey, through my career, I bumped into a thing called drugs. I got to a point where I couldn't stop. Somebody led me into the rooms of Narcotics Anonymous, and I sat down and I listened, and I heard my story, and I said, oh my God, I'm an addict. That was the beginning of my change. In 1993, I wrote a song with Steven Tyler called Amazing.
I kept the right ones out, let the wrong ones in.
And it was a song about our journey. What happened was, when the song became a huge Aerosmith hit, people started to realize what the song was about.
Trying to walk through the pain when I lost my.
And I started to get emails and people coming up to me and saying I was going to put a needle in my arm. And that song came on the radio, and I called somebody else for help instead. Thank you for writing that song. It planted a seed. Maybe I could use my gift as a songwriter to write songs about addiction. I went around to local detoxes and played these songs. I noticed the tears flowing and the crying and the sharing and suddenly the honesty, people opening up their hearts and talking about how sick and sick and suffering they are.
It's amazing. And I'm saying a prayer for the desperate hearts tonight.
Recovery Unplugged was born. It's been an amazing journey for me. Music is medicine. Humans are hardwired to respond to music. In fact, researchers have discovered brain cells that only react to the sound of music. Music enhances the pleasure centers of the brain, increasing dopamine levels and releasing endorphins. It also is a fact that it can change your heart rate. Music can be a catalyst for real change. It reduces anxiety, can help you manage pain, and even treat Alzheimer's and dementia. At Recovery Unplugged, we use it to treat addiction. Rock and roll, hip hop, classical, country, all genres of music contribute to the healing process. And yes, even reggaeton.
One, two, three.
We didn't invent the wheel. Music's been used in hospitals for years for pain management, Alzheimer's. What we did was apply it to addiction.
Come on!
Music is just a tool that we use to treat addiction. Playing classical music for clients in detox and, you know, charting on a scale how it helps with withdrawal symptoms, how it helps with anxiety, how it helps with depression. Recovery Unplugged is the antithesis of most treatment centers.
Many people want to say, oh, you do music therapy, and that's not the case. We don't do music therapy.
We use music as a catalyst to be able to open up a conversation or to kind of deepen what we're talking about in a specific topic.
If a song, if a verse, if a lyric, hell, if a word could actually inspire them to keep pushing, then we're gonna dig and we're gonna find what that recovery trigger is.
When they hear it through a song, it's non-threatening. and there's a certain connectivity that happens, and that's the magic of what music does. And that's how we use it in Recovery Unplugged. That's the essence of what Recovery Unplugged is. But I love you.